Good morning, students. Today we are going to start with the next chapter, chapter 13, network cabling. Okay, so in this chapter we are going to see about the necessity of cabling in computer networking and different types of cables we are used for networking, and also what are the components or involved in making for the internet cables, and also the types of registered jacks and its functions, then the wiring techniques, and also about the Ethernet cable. So we all know that nowadays we are using this internet, right? But in early days, while first they invented the computer, so Charles Babbage invented the computer first, and then people are looking for the new technologies which are equal to that computer. So in the same times, they find difficulties for sending any data from one place to another. So what they did, they started search for the networks. So then they find the internet. First they start the internet networks from one small place to another, then it extended to one place to a city, then now we are using the internet from one country, that means all over the world, right? So who invented internet? It was that means the World Wide Web was invented by the Tim Berners-Lee. So we know we are using internet and we are sending data through that internet. So this is we are using this in our own places. We are using the internet in our own places. But for using that internet, many network cables are used. So in this chapter, mainly we are going to see about the cables, what are the different types of cables that are used for the purpose of networking. Okay, so first one is that this is the types of network cables. Through that cables we can send data or communicate with one place to another. So first one are coaxial cable. So this cable, coaxial cable, means this cable was invented at the time of 1880, that is used to connect the television set to home antennas. So you all may, that means seen this, we are connecting the antennas cable, that it was somewhat big cable, you can see this cable, right? We are connecting this cable at the back of the our televisions for what? For the for the terms of getting the satellite connections or that cable connections. So that cable is called the coaxial cable. So this cable is used to transfer the information in 10 megabits per second. So this cable has the capacity of transferring the information at the rate of 10 megabits per second. And we can divide this cable into two types. What are they? Thin net and thick net. The cables have a copper wire inside, and insulation is covered on the top of the copper wire to provide protection to that cable. So how would this cable look like? Means this cable was insulated, having a copper wire inside, and in the outside of the copper wire it was covered with the insulation, that means a thick wire. It was covered thick plastic structure, no, not plastic, so insulation. So these cables are very difficult to install and maintain because they are too big to carry and replace. In the early, I think you all, I don't know, nowadays we are using these types of big cables, but in the early days the people used these types of cables for connecting the TV and their antennas, and it was big in size and it was very difficult to carry that cables. So what means, nowadays coaxial cables are also used for dish TV, where the setup box and the television is connected using the coaxial cable only. So in nowadays also we are using this coax cable for connecting the dish TV and the which are connected to the our televisions. Okay, so this is about the coaxial cable. So coaxial cable means it was invented in the year of 1880, and it will transfer the informations at the rate of 10 megabits per second. And also we can divide this coaxial cable into two types. They are thin net and thick net. And how this cable looks like means it have a copper wire insulated, just covered with insulation tape like structure in the outside. And it was very difficult to maintain because it was very big in size. And nowadays we are using this for the for connecting dish TV to the televisions. Okay, so this is the structure of the coaxial cable. And next one is the twisted pair cables. So twisted pair cable means it is also a type of cable with two or more insulated wires twisted together like this structure. So inside one tube, it have two or more wires which are twisted, means which are twisted with two wires which are rounded, twisted together. Okay, so that types of wire we are called like the twisted pair cables. So it has the speed of like 10 megabits per second. Then the cable was improved and the speed was higher and went to 100 megabits per second, and the cable was streamlined as 100 base TX. So while at the starting time the capacity of that wire was, it can able to send the it can able to send the data at the rate of only 10 megabits per second. Then as the days goes, it was developed, and now it has the capacity of, that means it has the higher capacity, high speed capacity for sending a data at the rate of 100 megabits per second. So we rename like 100 base TX. So then finally the cable was improved to 10 GPS and named as 10 base. So after that it was again developed to send the data in the speed of 10 gigabits per second. So we again renamed as 10 GBase T. So this twisted pair has 8 wires which are twisted to ignore electromagnetic interference. See the diagram. So here in this tube it has 8 wires. That means 4 pair which are twisted with each other, right? Then there are two types of twisted pair cables. They are unshielded twisted pair and shielded twisted pair. So the unshielded twisted pair is used nowadays as modern cable for internet, and they are lower in cost and installation and maintenance is easy compared to the coaxial cable. So unshielded pair was we are using it now in our modern days also we are using such types of unshielded pair. What are the uses? Means they are very low in cost and we can, it was easy for the maintenance. Okay, so next is STP. STP is also similar to UTP, but it is covered by an additional jacket to protect the wires. So STP means it is all the low cost and maintenance was easy. It was exactly have the same function like of UTP, but the extra point here is it have an additional protecting cover like jacket to protect the wires. So this is about the twisted pair cables. So twisted pair cable means here two or more wires which are twisted together, we can call like twisted pair cables. So the speed, first while it was in the early stage, it has the speed of 10 megabits per second. Then after it was developed to 100 megabits per second, then finally it was increased to 10 gigabits per second. Then this cable has 8 wires, that means 4 pairs which are twisted to
each other. And we can divide this twisted pair cable into two types. They are shielded twisted pair and unshielded twisted pair. Shielded means unshielded means it was low in cost, and the installation and maintenance was very easy for this unshielded twisted pair. But in the shielded twisted pair, you have an extra cover outside the wires. Okay, so this is about twisted pair cable. Then is the fiber optics. So fiber optics means this cable is different from the other two cables because the other two cable had an insulating material outside and a conducting material like copper inside. But in this cable, it is strands of glass and pulse of light is used to send the information. So this types of wire is called the fiber optic cables. Okay, so all other cables, the above, that means the above two types of cable have the wire inside and the protecting cover at the outside, right? But here it have the glass like structure, glass strands and a pulse of light is used to send the information. See here it have a glass like structure, no? So that is used for sending the informations from one place to another. That is you, that pulse of light or is used for communications. So they are mainly used in,
so these types of cables are used mainly in the wide area network. That means for the wide area network we are using this fiber optic cables. Okay, so these cables are placed in deep underground to avoid any damage to the cables. We are using these cables in the underground way so that we can avoid the damages to that cables. And these cables will use light to transmit the informations from one place to another. Here in these fiber optic cables we are using the light signals for sending the data or for communication purpose. There are two types of fiber optic cables. One is single mode and another one is the multi mode. So single mode are used for the sending the data for the long distance, and whereas the double mode we can use for the sending the information at a short distance. So these are the major differences of this single mode cable and the long double mode cable. Okay, so sorry, multi-mode cable. So this is about the fiber optics. So fiber optic means here this type of cable have two this is different from the other two cables because here we are using the glass like strands and the light signals for sending the data from one place to another. And here these types of cables are mainly used in WAN, that is wide area network, because using this network we can using these cables we can able to send the data for a larger distance. And we can divide this fiber optic cable into two types, that is single mode and multi mode. So single mode means we can able to send the data for a long distance, and multi mode means we can able to send the data for a short distance. So this is about the major differences between the single mode and multi mode. Next one is the USB cable. I think you all know about the USB cables. So the full form of USB is the universal serial bus. Okay, so these cables will used for connecting to the keyboard, mouse and other peripheral devices. So we can see this diagram. So these are the examples of USB cables. So we will use, nowadays we are using this USB cable in our mobiles for connecting our mobile to the system, or we are using this for the connecting the keyboards and for mouses, everything we are using this type of cables. And there are some special network devices used to connect the internet through the USB called dongles. So dongle means it is also a special type of network, special type of cable which are used to connect the network. It was like a pen drive sorry pen drive in like structure. Okay, it's a small pen drive like structure which we using this we can able to connect the network. So the dongle is a small peripheral device which has a compatible of mobile broadband with a slim slot in it and connect the internet and act as the modem to the computer. So using this dongle we can able to connect the network. Okay, so this is about the USB cables. The next one is the, so these are the types of USB cables. You all may notice these types of cables, right? Okay, next one is the serial and parallel cables. Earlier in 1980s to 1990s, the Ethernet and the USB were not developed. Then the serial and parallel interface cables were used to connect the internet to the system. They were something sometimes used for PC to PC networking also. We use this serial and parallel types of cables. So these are the the diagram shown here are the serial and parallel type of cables. These cables are used in the time of 1890s and 1990 times. We were used this type of cables at the time when the Ethernet and USB was not developed. We use this large pin sized cables. Okay, that cables are called the serial and parallel cables. So these cables are used for connecting PC, that means computer to computer. We will use these types of pins for connecting. And the serial port will send 1 bit at one time, whereas the parallel port will send 8 bit at one time. So the serial port the serial port pin has the capacity to send 1 bit at one time, but at the same time the parallel port has the capacity to send 8 bit at a single time. Okay, so these cables are used to connect the printer and other disk drives. So RS-232 is one type of serial cable, also known as null modem cable. So these types of cables are used to connect the printer and other disk drives. Nowadays also in some printers and all we are using such types of pins. And the example we can say is RS-232. So this is about the serial and parallel cables. Next one is the Ethernet cable. So Ethernet cable means it is the most common type of network cable mainly used for connecting the computers or devices at homes and offices. So this Ethernet cable is the common and mainly used device in computers and also in the devices we are using nowadays, using the homes, offices, all we are using these types of Ethernet cables. This cable connect wire devices within the local area network for sharing the resources and accessing the internet. So these are the wired network types and which can be used for the communication purpose. The crossover Ethernet cable is an example of null modem cables. So here this cable is used to join two PC or two network devices of the same type. So it has the capacity, this Ethernet cable has the capacity to join any two computers or any two network devices at the same time. Okay. So the speed of this Ethernet cables are 10 gigabits per second. So these are about the Ethernet cables. So these types of cables are used for connecting any two computers or any two internet devices at the same time. So nowadays we are using these Ethernet cables in all the places, like in home or in offices, for connecting the network we are using this Ethernet cables. But it was used only for the local area network, that means within a small area network only we can use this Ethernet cables. Okay, So these are about the types of cable. So the first one is the coaxial cable, then twisted pair cable, then fiber optics cable, then USB cable, serial and parallel cables, and Ethernet cables. These are the types of networking cables we are used for communicating purpose. Okay guys, thank you.